You should do your laboratory supposedly last week, right? And then on Friday, you have another exam, and that will be respiratory system and nasal, oral cavity, and your eyes, okay? So, but you have to study this also, okay? So you have your introduction to the neck and that's your child. So let's have first what you're supposed to have studied last time. Now, you were given model like this, right? Ito yung pinakita. And this model here that I'm showing you now, you have more detailed illustration of the different parts. Kesa dito sa unang pinakita ko sa inyo, right? Kesa dito. So here, previously, you had your... Okay? You had your nasal cavity here, okay? You discuss the nasal, the nose, okay? You divide that into external and internal nose. Internal is the nasal cavity, right? External, you have the root, you have the tip, and this is the dorsum or the bridge, but then some authorities, the bridge is just a part there where you have your nasal bone, okay? So you have the root here, so here, your nasal cavity, the internal nose, you have this one, okay? We'll be having two parts because separated by your limenasi, it's a ridge here. Separating your nasal vesicle inside the ala nasi, and this one is nasal cavity proper. Kung nandito naman ang oral cavity, this is oral vesicle between the lips, the cheeks outside, and teeth inside. That's oral vesicle, and this is oral cavity proper, right? So, nasal vesicle, and this one contains mucosae, so that you can drop that particulate matter. And this one here is your nasal cavity proper. And that will be your roof. And that will be your floor. Okay? Dito sa model na to, you have more detailed information, right? And so you have here your roof. It is made up of the nasal bone here, which is the yellow one. The blue is the frontal bone, and that's frontal sinus over there. And then this violet one here is ethmoid. That's why superior concha and middle concha are parts of ethmoid. And this red is orange is sphenoid. This is sphenoidal sinus here, okay? And in the model that you had before, this one, you have here in the lateral wall of the nasal cavity proper, you have three rolled up bones, shell-like. You call them conchas, tuberi. Superior concha, middle concha, inferior concha. In our lateral, you have superior canthus, middle canthus, inferior canthus. Pero dito sa model na to, you have more. If this one is superior concha, middle concha, inferior concha, and this is supreme concha. So, you see, however, you can see this. There is a smaller, okay, elevation there, which is sometimes present, okay? Supreme concha, supreme hiatus, this is superior concha, superior hiatus, middle concha, inferior concha, middle hiatus, inferior hiatus. And inferior hiatus, you'll be having here an opening which is coming from your eyes, and that will be your nasal umbilical duct. So ito yung model na to, makikita nyo. This is nasal umbilical duct there from the eyes. So, dito siya. You have here your nasal umbilical duct, and this is found in the pyramidus of your nose. Okay? So this one here. This is nasal lacrimal, sasya na pupunta sa inferior hiatus na nakapagyan na ng inferior concha. Okay? So this is where the beer is coming from, that they will not be possible. Okay, and then you have here your now all the sinuses, you have here the sinuses, frontal sinus, maxillary sinus, and you have here your superior concha and middle concha and middle concha at the lung here. So superior concha, middle concha, remove it, superior hiatus and middle hiatus, and here you have air spaces because these are parts of head. And you divide that into three if you follow step. Anterior, middle, and posterior void up. Okay? All the sinuses, they open into your middle hiatus. Except. Except this one. And the posterior void up. Sphenoid sinus, ito ethmoid to, ito sphenoid, ito sphenoid void up recess. Here is your mutas. And that is for sphenoid sinus. And then the posterior morda, dito siya sa superior hiatus. All the rest, they will be opening here in the middle hiatus. What? Frontal, maxillary, anterior, and middle, and morda. Okay? Ano pa trabaho ng mga sinuses? It's the mucus. So that you can moisturize your nasal mucosa. You don't want these to dry up, right? Okay. And so, the secretion will be now drained here into the nasal cavity. And if you have infection among here, the nose, if you have rhinitis, common colds, it can spread there in the sinuses and you'll be having sinusitis. Or if you have blockage in the drain, kaya lang, kasi yung secretion nila, yung post-madrain yan, kapag i-block sa drainage dito sa nasal cavity, ma-accumulate the secretion, you'll be having it's a total infection. You have sinusitis. Okay? And so, if you remove your middle concha, what do you have? So, dito, and this is middle hiatus, and superior hiatus, okay? And so, you have here superior concha, and you just remove your middle concha, so it's just middle hiatus. And what you find here, you have a sieve-like passageway. May makikita na yung ganyan. Okay? You call this hiatus semilunaris. Hiatus semilunaris. And here, okay, it's bounded up by around this elevation. Bula is vowel. Bula and molaris. And that is due to the middle and molar. And bounded below by like coordinate process of the ethmoid. Hiatus semilunaris, that's bula and voidalis up. So to sa cadaver, may elevated na structure doon, bula and voidalis yun, right? And then if you have hiatus semilunaris, and this is from the sinus there, there would be now proctal nasal lung that opens here into your infundibulum, which is fundus lame, and going to your hiatus semilunaris. And then here, you should see that there's an opening there. And this opening is the opening of your maxillary sinus. See that there? Okay. And so, that's an opening of maxillary sinus. So, it's easy to understand kung bakit pag may frontal sinusitis, ang dalili niya mag-complicate sa maxillary sinusitis, di ba? Due to gravity infection doon. Pumunta dito sa maxillary. At madali dinihin, if you see your opening here, kung bakit, if you have maxillary sinusitis, ang hirap niya pumaling kasi yung secretion niya, ang hirap i-drain out kasi nasa itaas yung opening into the nasal cavity there. Right? And then, if you have here your premolar upper teeth, molar teeth, the roots there will be related with the maxillary sinus. Kaya if you have abscesses there, in the roots of this upper teeth there, okay, you can have maxillary sinusitis, okay? So that will be now your middle hiatus. And so you can see that here. If you remove that and the shaft, dito, and to ang Supreme Concha, Supreme Yatus, and Superior Concha has been a little bit removed here, and you have your Superior Yatus, and that is where Postil and Wardo cells will open. Tapos ito, tinanggal yung middle concha, tinanggal. So ito, nakikita yung pinag to, so ito yung long middle concha, tinanggal yun, tinanggal na ganyan. At nakita nyo dito, middle yatus, and then sa yatus, and nalis. Tapos ito, bilog na bilog, kaya lang, ito lang ang butas-butas, the openings of the middle and moida, there. Okay? And this is ulcinate process of the airport. Tapos, nandito yung opening na maxillary, kaya kapag may obstruction sa opening ng maxillary sinus, sometimes they do surgery, tinatanggal nila ito, ulcinate process, you call that ulcinectomy. Okay? So, kailangan mag-drain out yung mga secretions coming from the sinuses. Okay? And then, if you have now here, your nasal cavity, and that's lateral wood, and this is now your, my hand is a nasal septum, and this is nasal pharynx, and then you have here, and then you have concha here, you have two openings there, between the nasal cavity and the nasal pharynx, you call it quane, tube line, quane or posterioris, ito, anterioris, yun ang dito, between nasal cavity and nasal pharynx, posterioris or quane, okay? And then you have your nasal pharynx. The root here, this is purely respiratory. The root is, what is this? Pharyngeal tonsil or adenoid tonsil, right? Okay? And here, the lateral wall, can you see this? At the back, okay, can you see what opening is this? You see the tube, okay? And then you see the tube is the one that connects the middle ear and the nasal pharynx. Okay? And this one is always closed. Palagi siyang sarado. Ano ba trabaho niya? Okay? Pag nagbukas niya, pag nagbukas siya, air can go in or out. Para ang air pressure dito on both sides will be equal. Diba? Pag nag-take off sa airplane or landing, ang equal dito. So, you have to open this. How about you do? You swallow, or you chew, or you yawn. And this one opens. And so, the air can go in or out. Okay? And so, this one is always closed, except when you swallow. You use your batas. But you need your batas, right? So, you can swallow. Okay? And then, this one is opened by muscle. Like this one here is a pharyngeal muscle covered by a pharyngeal bone. And also tensor tympani, they open. Okay? If this one is always closed. Tapos ito, elevation na yun, ay dahil sa cartilage ng shape. So, testolus, varius. And then you'll be having tubal tonsils there. And then, you have now, here at the back, kung magkakaroon ng cancer dito sa nasal pharynx, dito siya. Ang tawag dito, pharyngeal recess. Or, Rosenmuller fossa. Okay? So, yan ang common site na, ano? Common site na cancer sa nasal pharynx. Rosen, Muller, Rosa. Dr. Rosen Muller. Okay? So, that's nasal pharynx. And this one is oral pharynx. If you have your oral cavity, just like dito, it's divided, the nasal cavity is divided to nasal vesicle and nasal cavity proper. Dito ng oral cavity, this one is oral vesicle and oral cavity proper. Okay? Now, the root of the oral cavity is the floor of your nasal cavity. And the floor is, okay, is made up of the hard palate. Ito, itong brown na ito, tsaka yung brown na yan, ay maxilla. It's palatine process of maxilla. Itong blue naman na ito, yung blue na yan, palatine. And this one is always on the plate of palatine bone. Ito, hard palate. Itong blue na yan, tsaka pinky, tsaka the nasal packages. Okay? So, here is hard palate, maxilla, and palatine. Palatine process of maxilla, and also the plate of this palatine bone. Okay? So, that's the that's the root of your oral cavity, okay? And here, if you have anterior two-thirds at the top,
nasa oral copy siya.
Okay? At year 2, tapos yung 1-3 po tonsil yan. At year 2, there's nasa oral copy, pero ito nasa oral pharynx po si 1-3 po tonsil yan. In between then, your sulcus and pinalis, and that will be foramen sicum. Ang foramen sicum dito ay ito, and maybe depression dito, a pouch, blind pouch. Okay? And there's a remnant of fibroglossal duct. Ano ito? What? Tonsil. And here, nandito yung palatine tonsil na kapag na-trim yung po na tonsillitis, and yung palatoglossal arch, palatoparichial arch. So you have here, palatoglossal arch, palatoparichial arch. That's palatine tonsils. Kung sa oral, sa pasis, nasal, pharynx, dapat pangit lang ang dadaan dyan. And then this one is oral pharynx, which is digestive or respiratory. Pero hindi pong bunga sa pagitan. Pharyngeal isthmus. And each it goes when you swallow. You don't want the food going there, right? This one is supplied by sensory fibers of trigeminal maxillary. Pharyngeal isthmus should close. Okay? And you have muscles here that will do that. So that the food will not go to the nasal pharynx. Kailangan, dito na siya sa oral, the lingual pharynx is off loose, right? And so you have lingual tonsil here, palatine, what's that? Palatine tonsils. If you open up your mouth, and this is a palate, top should be na to palato, closer arch, and this is palatine tonsil, and this is the tongue. Yung putas na to sa pagitan ng oral cavity at sa oral pharynx, ang tawag ng oral pharyngeal isthmus of process. Okay? Ang tawag naman dito, pharyngeal isthmus. Ang tawag naman sa oral cavity, okay, opening oral cavity and oral pharynx is oral pharyngeal isthmus of process. Okay? And then you have the tongue here, and this one at the bottom of the tongue is lip, what's this? Epiglottis. Okay, at the bottom of the lingual tonsil, right? This is epiglottis, and the depression there in between is valvula, okay? And here, this is the inside of the larynx. So you have to review again the larynx here, together with the different muscles there, right? Okay, at the bottom of the tongue, what is this? Epiglottis, and this is thyroid cartilage, right? Lamina there, and this is Adam's apple, the liver prominence. May halag, may ilin, ayaw mo na tutulungan. And then sa liver, you have horn, what is that? Sipiopornum is horn, sipiopornum. Okay? And then you have here, of course, this is thyroid. And picoid means ring of cartilage. Before, side, back. Arch of picoid, you put the lamina of picoid. Tapos may lamina of arytenoid. At the apex may be low or neglects. And from the apex of arytenoid to the epiglottis, there's mucosa fold. Arytenoid fold, tapos may butas siya. Na pagsasarado, pag kumakit kayo, nagpagmasarado siya. Para hindi butas sa lower respiratory tract, pinirinahin niyo, right? Butas sa larigo, pharynx, and troubles. This one should close. You call that the lingual inlet. Okay? So here, you should review again this one. This one is your, what is this? Myoid. At the back of the tongue, what is this? Epiglottis. And this is front, this is back, what is this? Thyroid. This one is picoid. This is arytenoid. That's really great. Arytenoidic fold. Anong pharynx dito? Laryngo pharynx. And then you have another arytenoidic fold on the left side. So there's an opening here. Pangalan, and it should close when you swallow, okay? And you have two mucosal folds here. One is up and fixed. False vocal cord, or similar fold. One is down and normal. And when this one vibrates, it produces sound. What is this? True vocal cord or vocal fold. Okay, and this is the radial, what's that? Ventricle, okay? So you have to review that again And then you have two CDs. Okay? Now here, ito siya. Ito yung likod na ng larynx, right? Ang nandito sa likod niya, nandito laryngopharynx. Ang ginawa dito, pinuksan yung laryngopharynx dito. Nakabuka sa laryngopharynx. But you can see a part of the laryngopharynx here. Okay? So the laryngopharynx has been removed. Okay? And at the back. The part of the laryngopharynx is there. Now this one is the laryngeal finger. And this one is the back of your cricoid. Ito back ng cricoid there. Ito back na arytenoid. Okay? Ito back na arytenoid. And you apex on cornea, you need to delay. Okay? Ayun ang cornea delay there. Okay? Ito yung back ng cricoid. Ito back na arytenoid. And that's cornea delay. Ito naman epiglottis. Epis is all epiglottic fold. What is this opening here? And it just flows when you swallow. And this one is laryngopharynx that you see there at the bottom. And the part of laryngopharynx that you see on the other side of your body, you go to fall there. People usually nalalagay mga tinitinit, fish bones, chicken bones, okay? Ang tawag dito, feeding for recess. Ano tawag dito sa usual site of cancer dito? Pharyngeal recess or Rosenmuller fossa. Dito, dito. Pharyngeal recess. Ito na mga pangalan dito. Piriform recess or piriform fossa or smuggler's fossa. So this is smuggler's fossa here. Okay, so that's your laryngeal index. And then, you should study again your okay. You should study again the preserved specimens of the nasal cavity. This one here is your nasal vesicle. This is your root of the nose. This is a front. This is a back. Okay, nasal vesicle. This is lingual nasi. This is the lips and the teeth. This is oral residue. This is nasal cavity proper. This is oral cavity proper. Okay? And you have here at the lateral wall of the nasal cavity proper, this one is inferior nasal concha, inferior nasal concha, superior deep masyado makita. But this is middle hiatus. What is this? Inferior hiatus. This one is nasopharynx. That's pharyngeal tonsil. Yet, since Pikachu, you have elevation, torus, varius. And then today is a sativa pharyngeal fold. And this is soft palate. This is what pharynx, oropharynx. At the back of the tongue, what is this? Epiglottis. Nasal vesicle, what is this? Oral vesicle. Okay? So you should know that. And then, after your also that there, hindi lang kayo nakakaamoy sa upper one-third. Ito si Pio Poncha, Pio Poncha, and Pio Poncha. Hindi lang sa upper one-third at the nasal mucosa. That's where you can smell. That's why you have to have the ear passing there so you can smell it. You cannot do mouth breathing, right? You have to filter. You have to warm madaming blood vessels now. You have to moisten, moisturize the ear so it will not dry up because cold air and dry air will destroy everything down here, respiratory tract. Okay? And so, your topic today, and so you have to study also this part of your body, and that's the neck. So there's a medical word for neck. And that's cervix. Diba? Yung regular naman is cervix. Tawag dito sa mga puto sa likod na neck. No? Cervical vertebrae. Cervix is neck. So you have down here your midline. Okay? There will be two structures here, separated by sternum by the muscle. Anterior Cervical Triangle, Medial Cervical Triangle. Ano ba ba ito? Ina. Your border muscle, cervical muscle. Posterior triangle, what is this? Cervical muscle, what is that? The tissue, and this is, if you have the clavicle, if you have the clavicle, and now, if you have the clavicle, all right, the clavicle. Ito yung dini niya. Ito medial, medial, and ito, lateral, and ito medial. Napapatakin sila. Medial one-third, lateral one-third, ito, medial. Medial, ito, lateral, ito, medial. So you can keep your boundary. And then, you divide the striders, it's water, but it's a muscle. Ito, drink ito, okay, any possibility. Ito, hip na ito, thermal shoulder coming from scapula to the hyoid. If you're ready or from ions, if you're ready or from what. So I put there the names. And then these are the other things, okay? That's the common names that I underline, okay? The first one, mental is cheap, so nandito siya. So mental. And then here, sa libra. So yung inagyan ng mga blood test, mga artery stretches of myelin. Number four, nandiyan yung mga muscles attached to the myoid below. Okay, that would be your muscular triangle. Number five is fascia. Number six is among the clavicle. So supra, clavicula. So dapat alam nyo yung mga pangalan na yan. Right? So you have the different triangles here. Again, this one is magnetic. Anterior, ito. Posterior. See a muscle. Muscle, this one. The tissues. And this is the midline. What is this? Anterior belly of the gastric. Posterior belly of the gastric. The side of myoid. Okay, anong triangle ito? Sub, mental, ito. Sub, mental. Okay, tapos ito. Artery, and then you want to have to say, this one, you can do more muscles in your deeper muscle, muscles. And then this is?
This is about the middle water.
Supra. And that's why you want the third portion of the subclinium. So, you want to have the subclinium triangle. Okay? So, ano ba gagawin nyo? Ang gagawin, 1 to 4 ba? That they say, and then 5 to 8 will stay here for the models, but then be sure at the end of the period that you have seen anything, okay? So, ano gagawin nyo dito? Papatali na skin. And the first thing that you see there in the superficial fascia, underneath the skin, is muscle, the only muscle here. Now, kapag masigit yung period, latissima, it's flat, okay? Latissima. What else you see here? Ito ang vein na ito. What is that? External jugular vein. In the superficial fascia underneath. What else do you see there? Mga nerves, parang yung mga rangka. Touch. Okay, I think it was a little. Touch. Pressure, pain, temperature. Branches of the cervical plexus. Okay? So, itong dilaw na ito, papunta dito sa parapet, is greater or regular. C2C vein. Ito naman papunta sa harapan, transverse vertical. Ito papunta sa itaas ng clavicle, supracodular, C3C4. Para makakanta, these are all sensory nerves. Okay? Where did my hand? Superficial fascia. Where is superficial fascia? Underneath your skin. What muscle? The isma. What vein? External jugular. And then you see those nerves, right? Okay. And then, okay, so here is a tibetanastic, or tibetanastic. What type is it? Ito maliit na yan. Submental, ito. Submental. And then this is a midline. So anong triangle? Ito, superbelly of omohyoid, superbelly of omohyoid. Ito, infrahyoid muscles, right? Sternohyoid. What's that? Sternohyoid. Sa ilalim, sternohyoid. Hyomyoid, and this one here is what? What is that? Hyomyoid. Okay? What is this? Ano nga ito? ito? Sir Kyron. Ito, tinanggal siya. Ang nakita niyo ito, ano to? Sir Kyron. And then, Kyron. And then, lateral to this. This is lateral to this. What is this one here?
Kyron.
These are found in number 4. Muscular triangle. Okay? These are the strap muscles. Okay, what is this? Sternocleidomastoid. What is this? Inferior belly of hyoid. On the shoulder from scapula to going to the hyoid. Okay? What triangle is this?
Supraclavicular.
Okay, and then you have now here. Okay.
Ano ba makikita nyo sa posterior triangle?
At the floor of the posterior triangle. You see here muscles. And some of these are attached to the first rib and second rib. First rib, ipapansin natin yung, okay, sa tripod, is kalit triangle. Yung triangle na hindi equal yung size niya. Yung tatlong parte, pero hindi, you have an equal size. Is kalit na tawag doon. Okay? So, these are muscles that need a part of the shape. Is kalit. And those is going to be attached or first rib is easily anterior and medius. How do you know? You have brachial plexus going to the upper extremities, groupings of nerves, and then you have subclavian artery. And then, ito naman, kung isan ay absent, okay? Ano ba nyo, okay? Sabi last night, 51 lang ang absent to sa microbiome. Okay, you have in your second rib, what is that? Iscaline posterior. Nakatawin sa inyo, iscaline posterior. Okay, this one is iscaline anterior and medial. Okay, and then you have here your structures that you have here. Ito, dito sa likod. Okay, ganyan siya. Okay. So here, this is a muscle for shrugging the shoulder. This is what? The tissues. Okay? And underneath that one, this muscle here, ito ang mula dyan, hanggang dito. And it's completely raised to the mastoid, like a band. Splenium is band or muscle. Splenius, tapitis. Yeah. So ilalim yan, straight. Is where and here in your line. What is this? Semispinalis capillis. Ito ulit. Splenius capillis. Ito? Semispinalis capillis. Tapos nandito yung scapula. Nandito yung scapula there. Attached there to the region of the scapula. Levator, scapula. Makikita niyo ito sa posterior triangle. Okay? Again, ano ito? Splenius capillis. Ano? Semispinalis. What is this? Levator, scapula. Okay, and then you see now here. Okay, this is posterior triangle. Pero dito, nawawala si iscaline posterior. Okay, at wala din if you're very on homo hyoid. This is sternocleidomastoid. So, ano ba ito? Sternocleidomastoid. Underneath the skin, and the tissues. And then this one here is splenius capitis. And this one, semispinalis capitis. This is levator scapula. Tapos dalawa na lang natin na nawala si iscaline posterior, iscaline medius, and iscaline anterior. Okay? But then, this one here is, what is this? Sternocleidomastoid. This one? The tissues, what they? Sternocleidomastoid. If sternocleidomastoid, may saan siya mapupunta? Subclavian vein. It drains into subclavian vein below. Okay? And then you have the muscles at the posterior triangle. Ano to? The splenius capitis. Yun ang dito. Semispinalis. Itong blue. Levator scapula. Tapos itong pinakamaliit, iscaline posterior.
Metacarpal flexor, so this must be iscaline, anterior and iscaline what? Okay, ganun lang. Okay? And then, yung isa. Isa naman. Okay? You have now here, meron dito, ano, meron dito, if you're very open, ayoy, nandito, okay? So, again, what is this? Spinous capillaries. Ay, yun ang semi-spinal. What is this? Elevator scapula. Ay, dito muna pala. Ginagalisig, nakaka-superficial fascia, nakaka-platista, and also brain. What is that?
Cervical.
And also, branches of your cervical plexus going to your ear, the brina, and then part of the LNC there. Later or later, C2C3, papunta sa harapan, transverse vertical, papunta dito sa gilid ng occipital region, sa lateral side, dito, lesser occipital, dito, dito, greater occipital. So this is lesser occipital C2 at your ramus. This is greater occipital C2 or your ramus. Okay? And so here, nandito yung inferior belly or omo, hyoid. Ano ulit ito? Iscaline. Spinous capillaries. Ito? Ito scapula. Ito iscaline. Ito, breaker plexus yung dilaw na yan, tsaka sa cavia. So, ano kaya ito? Iscaline reduced. Ito kaya? Iscaline anterior. Ano to? Inferior belly or omo, hyoid. Ano triangle to class? Posterior triangle. Okay. So that's it. Okay. So these are the things that you have in your field. And then those will be left here. We just have to see the models. And I took pictures of the models here. Now we see it. Okay, so ito, you have here, the fissures. And the fissures arises from your external cervical protuberance, you're going to do really want to detail. It's right here, the outer border of your spine scapula or of your clavicle. Ano trabaho nito? Shrugging the shoulder. Okay? So it shrugs the shoulder. Nerve supply, just like sternocleidomastoid, is spinal accessory. Okay? And then, pag tinanggalin the fissures, alam mo yung kung ano itong muscle na to? Epidural. Ito. Sternocleidomastoid. Okay? Attach yun dito sa mastoid. Ito is kind of like so, sa ilalim yun, ano to? Spinous capillaries. Ito. Ito is kind of like muscle. Nakaganyan dyan. Okay? Sa ilalim, what is this? Spinous capillaries. Sa ilalim pa niya, ano to? Semispinalis capillaries. And underneath that, you have submucosal muscles, right? Submucosal triangle. And then this one is a scapula here. And this is levator scapula. Okay? And then you see here nerves. From C2 at T-ramus, what is that? Lesser occipital. C2 to C-ramus, greater occipital. Ang cervical plexus at T-ramus lang. Kaya C2, greater occipital, hindi kasali. Right? And then, you come here. Here.
one here is your, what is that? Lesser of C2, C2 and P Ramos, and this is what? Greater of C2 of C Ramos. Okay? So that will be now your sternocleidomastoid. Like muscle. I think it will be better that you see them closely. Okay?